Good morning, everybody. Today, I am Moksh Malik from Rabindranath School. Stand before you to present the famous monologue delivered by Mark Antony in Shakespeare's Jubilee season. It is one of the most thrilling moments in the play. Antony's speech is an excellent example of rhetoric and verbal ability. Using his oratory skills, Antony instigates the mobs against the conspirators. The purpose of Antony's speech was to show tribute to his friend Caesar, and he wanted the audience to revolt and seek revenge for his friend's brutal murder. Let's begin. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do live after them. The good is often turned in their bones. So let it be with Caesar. The noble Brutus hath told you that Caesar was ambitious. If it was so, it was a grievous fault. And grievously hath Caesar answered it. Here, under leave of Brutus and the rest. For Brutus is an honorable man. So are they all honorable men. Come, I to speak in Caesar's funeral. He was my friend, faithful and just to me. But Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. He hath brought many captives home to Rome, whose ransoms did the general coffers fill? Did this in Caesar seem ambition? When the poor have pride, Caesar had wept. Ambition should be made of sterner stuff. Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. You all did see at the Lubecker, I thrice offered him the kingly crown, which he did thrice refuse. Was this ambition? Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and sure he is an honorable man. I speak not to disprove what Brutus spoke, but here I am to speak what I do know. You all did love him once, without any cause. What cause beholds you now to mourn for him? O judgment, thou art fled to brutish beasts, and men have lost their reason. Bear with me. My heart is in the coffin there with Caesar, and I must force till it come back to me. Thank you.